In 1968, America was embroiled in protests over civil rights in the Vietnam War. In that tumultuous time, Tonight Show host Johnny Carson turned over his hosting duties for an entire week to actor and activist Harry Belafonte. Belafonte's guests, mostly African American, included Martin Luther King Jr., Lena Horne, and Bobby Kennedy. It was a week, though, almost lost in history, but now revisited in a documentary called The Sit-In, airing Thursday on NBC's streaming platform Peacock. I recently spoke with The Sit-In's director, Yoruba Richen, and producer, Joan Walsh. Thank you so much for talking to us about this documentary. I'm just curious, how did this all come to pass in 1968 with Harry Belafonte actually sitting in for Johnny Carson? And we're talking about during a period of great civil unrest, there were anti-war demonstrations. How was it that Harry Belafonte got to do this for a whole week on the Johnny Carson's Tonight Show?
Well, from what we know, Michael, Johnny Carson really cared about these issues. We don't think of him as a political person, but he had a lot of concern about race relations. He was a little bit ahead of his time, partly because he was in the entertainment business. He was close to Harry, and he wanted to turn the show over so that Harry could showcase his view of the world for a full week. And he got backup from NBC executives also, which was pretty amazing, as you said, given the time.
I also think Harry was such a huge star at that time. And it's we sometimes don't remember, he was multi-platform, TV, film, movies. And I think that Johnny thought he was the guy, literally he was the guy who could do it, who could speak to a national audience about these issues and be entertaining.
Because of what Harry was already doing. I mean, some of the film goes into what Harry was doing in the 1950s and on stage with diverse cast members and so forth. So I guess to a certain extent that made it, quote, more acceptable to America's audience?
Yeah, I mean, I think Harry was a huge superstar for everyone, black, white. And we say in the film, it's pretty amazing for him to be appealing to white audiences during these times of segregation. There are only a few, very few, who did that. I think of Sammy Davis Jr. And Harry.
I would imagine that the network executives still, though, were nervous about the content of what he was going to talk about, because after all, Belafonte was not a comedian.
Part of his negotiation, he was very, very, he's very humble in our documentary as well. He says, I didn't think I was ready to take Johnny Carson's chair, and I don't tell jokes, and I'm just not that guy. So he also negotiated that he would sing a song each night instead of doing a stand-up kind of monologue, and that was the accommodation they made with his type of stardom.
It was astounding to see the caliber of people who were on this show, just the two that were recorded as far as we can tell. And it was astounding. I mean, you had Dr. King sitting next to Paul Newman, sitting next to Leon Bibb, sitting next to Nipsey Russell. I mean, it's just, it's amazing to see.
You'd never see it anywhere else.
I think it shows his reach, right? His reach into the political world and into the entertainment world. You know, it's one of those people, it's like, the one for the ages, where people want to be around him. People, his intelligence, his talent, his commitment, his loyalty is what got all those people together to have that kind of lineup that week.
When you started on this journey with this documentary, I'm just curious for both of you, what astounded you about this week of hosting the Johnny Carson Tonight Show for Harry Belafonte? What astounded you?
The diversity of his guests, the quality of his guests, the way that he handled himself as an interviewer, which is, it's not that easy. If it looks easy, you're doing a good job, because it's really not easy. And so he stepped into that role so seamlessly, and also brought both humor and commitment. So those were some of the main things.
Yeah, I mean, the fact that I didn't know about it. I mean, when Joan and the producers approached me about directing the film, I was immediately interested because I didn't know about it. But also the fact that it wasn't until many years later, till Arsenio Hall, that we have not had another host. I mean, Harry was host for just that week. He was the first African-American host of that week. And then, you know, a long dry period until we had another African-American host of late night. And we still have a problem there around diversity in late night. So that's also astounding.
Right. I want to play a clip, and the clip has to do with Harry Belafonte going back to The Tonight Show within a month or so of him hosting the show.
Did you have a ball with it? I caught you a couple of nights. Looks like you're having a great time.
I had a marvelous time. The grooviest time in the world here, the week that I spent here.
We ended with ratings that were larger than the ones we opened with, and we opened with the largest numbers in the history of the show.
And he also talks about, I think the documentary shows, the list of guests that he had on, and phenomenal. And then he talks about thank you for the sit-in, which is just, I mean, unless you know history, there's so many people who may not catch that. I mean, this was Harry Belafonte, then, now, whenever, awfully clever entertainer.
Very, very clever. I mean, we found out about that he called it the sit-in semi-late in the process. Someone reached out to me who happened to be Johnny Carson's secretary in that time period. And she was so excited that the week was being written about. And she sent me a copy. He took out a full-page ad in Variety thanking not only all of his guests, but also the staffers on The Tonight Show who helped. But at the top, he says, you know, thanks to all of you who joined me at this sit-in, you know, and a sit-in is not a neutral term at that point. You know, the civil rights movement, the modern civil rights movement, in some ways, it started with, well, Rosa Parks sitting in, but also the students sitting in at lunch counters, you know, college students sitting in around the Vietnam War. So it wasn't just a, you know, like a funny throw off line. It just showed that he saw what he did in a friendly way as a political act, not just a, you know, well, we had a great week and we got great ratings.
Yeah, it's a brilliant move to call it a sit-in, which of course is our title of our film. You know, not that we were the brilliant ones, Harry was the brilliant one to do it, and to bring that kind of politics again to a mainstream in Variety, in right. On The Tonight Show. You know, and that's sort of the history. You know, so much of his work that he was doing, bringing those politics for some radical into the mainstream.
It's a terrific film. I hope a lot of people get a chance to see it. It's called The Sit-In, just as Harry Belafonte penned it way back in 1968. And we're talking to the director, Yoruba Richen, and we're talking to the producer, of course, Joan Walsh. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having us.